Welcome to Lavonne at Home. Today we'll be making the classic English Bakewell tart. It has a crumbly base with a soft vanilla sponge and a sweet and sour berry jam. Let's begin with our vanilla sablé base. Start off by adding sieve flour and icing sugar, along with almond flour and salt into a mixing bowl. Add cold cube butter straight out of the fridge. Combine these ingredients in a tabletop mixer and use the paddle attachment on medium speed until you get a nice breadcrumb consistency. Add in the milk as well and mix until a rough dough is formed. You could also do all of this using just a spatula and it should turn out the same. Transfer the dough onto a work surface and knead it gently so it comes together. Then place the dough between two sheets of butter paper and roll it out to around 4 millimeters thickness. Once the dough is sheeted to a nice even thickness, let's leave it in the refrigerator for 20 minutes. Meanwhile, get the baking ring ready by greasing it generously with butter. Take the cooled sheeted pie dough out from the refrigerator and cut a disc of dough using a baking ring two sizes bigger than our final pie ring. Check that the disc of dough is feeling soft and flexible against your fingers and gently work the dough evenly against the sides to line the ring, making sure that there are no air pockets along the way. Trim off any excess from the top of the ring and let's put the pie base to cool in the refrigerator for now. Moving on to our berry jam. Place the berries in a heavy bottom pan along with the first part of sugar. Start cooking over medium-low heat until the berries release water. Meanwhile, in another bowl, use a spoon or whisk to mix the yellow pectin with the second part of sugar. Pectin is, of course, a natural gelling agent that helps thicken our jams and jellies. Once the pot is steaming, drizzle in the pectin sugar mix one spoon at a time, stirring with a spatula after every addition to avoid any lumps. Continue cooking the mixture on a medium-low heat until your jam starts to thicken enough to coat the back of a spoon. This should take about 2 to 3 minutes. Once done, switch off the heat, squeeze in some lemon juice and mix until well combined. Transfer the jam into another bowl and set it aside to cool and refrigerate until use. Lastly, we make a pound cake. Put the caster sugar and soft butter in a large bowl. Use a hand blender to cream the two until light and fluffy. Now start adding in the eggs gradually in parts. Be sure to mix well after every addition so that the eggs are always completely mixed in before adding more. Mix in the vanilla as well. Next up, add in half the amount of flour and mix on low speed until combined. Then add in the remaining half and aim for the batter to come together nice and smooth. Feel free to use a spatula to scrape the sides of the bowl . Transfer the batter into a piping bag and get ready to assemble this delicious tart. Time for assembly. grab your lined tart base and start filling in some of the jam. Spread it evenly across the base using a spoon or an offset spatula to fill about a quarter of the tart. Next, pipe the pound cake batter on top of the jam to fill the remaining three quarters of the tart. Let's also sprinkle some soaked almond flakes over the top as a nice garnish. Soaking almond flakes just helps them bake evenly. Bake this in a preheated oven at 170 degrees Celsius for 15 to 17 minutes. Take the tray out of the oven and keep it on a counter to cool for about 15 minutes. Once cool enough to be handled, top them off with some mixed berries in the center and dust icing sugar around the edges using a fine mesh sieve. Take a well-deserved bite of your delicious Bakewell tart. When you're ready for your next baking adventure, you'll find a ton of amazing cakes, tarts, and desserts to make along with us in your kitchen, right here on Lavonne at Home.